John Tron is a figure of the online world that needs no introduction, but here's one anyway. He's a YouTuber who began creating comedic game reviews in mid-2010. This was in the wake of the angry review trend set by the Angry Video Game Nerd, among others. Even though John's earlier videos took heavy inspiration from these creators, he would soon find his own clear-cut path and branched out from the rest, most of whom have since faded away in the online space. All while John has grown to such an extent that he's even surpassed James Rolfe himself, who is one of the few to have also persisted over the years. Along the way, many came to see that John's videos are unique and that they possess humor that was unlike anything any other creator could pull off. This was because, on top of being a clever comedian, John has no set format for his videos and will go to great lengths with time and money to pull them off. His channel is almost exclusively quality over quantity, and uploads are slow, but satiate his audience who is more than willing to wait. This is why subscribers are so keen on preserving content that goes missing from John, who will often take down videos he no longer considers fitting on the channel. Because of how active his fanbase is, most things that go missing on the channel don't vanish for long. And this has been true for the entirety of the time since John created his main channel. Today, 34 videos are known to have been unlisted from it. Some being charity live streams, older relevant channel updates, announcements, or promotional videos for merch that were never public in the first place. But also some of his primary content that he grew dissatisfied with. Some of these were serious reviews, which he dabbled in for a brief period, as well as sponsored videos like How to Play Smite and Being Scared at Resident Evil 7 on PSVR. 6 top 10 videos were also taken down, each for different reasons or seemingly no reason at all, unlike these other video styles which were purged en masse. Although, this isn't unique to top 10s. Several other videos like George Lucas and JonTron Visit Jupiter were also taken down for seemingly no reason other than the fact that John doesn't believe they fit on the channel anymore. And many others have been fully privated for the same reason. It's understandable to some extent since most creators feel some level of discomfort towards their older content, but John is one of the most noteworthy examples of a figure who removes it. But videos deleted from the JonTron channel aren't always due to John himself. There have been a handful of times that YouTube or the public contribute to his content going missing. For instance, his Jurassic Park The Lost Potential review was blocked for copyright reasons, causing John to post an announcement saying all movie reviews would be posted on his website instead.
So YouTube.com is a dangerous place for movie reviews. So here's what I'm doing. I'm taking the Jurassic Park video that was on my channel, taking it off my channel, and then putting a link to it here on my channel that goes to my website. So you can watch it. It's the same video. Whenever I do a movie review, I'm gonna put it on the YouTube and say, go watch it somewhere else.
He linked a blip.tv mirror of the video, but this site would eventually go offline entirely, and both the Jurassic Park review and announcement video were taken down with it, and became JonTron Lost Media. But thankfully, YouTube amended their copyright policies enough to allow John to go back on his word of keeping future reviews off the main channel. Unfortunately though, history repeated itself when the same issue occurred with JonTron's Christmas with the Cranks review that was taken down for similar reasons, causing it to be stuck in copyright limbo for months after its initial upload. Before finally, the block was lifted and it was once again viewable on the channel. There were also several other videos taken down due to small controversies occurring with the content, including 2 episodes of Gaming in the Public and his top 10 overrated games review. But these were already talked about in greater detail in another video about JonTron's Lost Media by The Gamer from Mars. And for all of my subscribers who may notice something fishy, yes, this is the second time, almost in a row, that I've made a Lost Videos episode about a YouTuber Gamer from Mars had covered first. It's not intentional, but it is embarrassing either way. I'll put a link below, just watch his video once you finish up mine, then everyone's happy. As stated though, JonTron's fanbase has remained dedicated enough to collect nearly everything over the years. But the most notoriously difficult to find was a little video called Apples and Breaks. It was nothing more than a minute-long skit where John talks about having broken his Nintendo DS, but with it being unavailable, fans grew anxious to see it for themselves. This led to a search that lasted from late 2012 to early 2015, before eventually it resurfaced when a user known as Fisha13 found that he'd burned it to a DVD along with other JonTron episodes years ago. Again, I'd recommend you check out the Gamer from Mars video since the search for Apples and Breaks was covered much better by him. It's probably one of the most fascinating Lost Media hunts relating to John, and there have been quite a few of them. Videos have resurfaced countless times on countless channels over the years, the most popular of which being JonTron Archive, which has nearly 120,000 subscribers as of now. As far as I can tell, this channel has everything with the exception of 4 videos, a 2018 charity livestream, a merch announcement video, John's segment in an interactive video collab called Dodger Effect, and a Super Mario Bros. Melee fight John appeared in, all of which were posted to the JonTron channel and are still viewable as unlisted videos. Beyond that, though, defining what is and isn't lost JonTron media gets a bit complicated. There are several instances where Jon has abandoned episodes midway through, and clips from these have been shown at conventions.
Sometimes a project just doesn't go how you expect it to. It's perfectly normal and part of the process. This video here was going to be on the collection of Disneyland games. I don't know if I'm ever going to release it, so I might as well show you some silly bits from it. Enjoy! If only there was some way to truly experience the magic of the Magic Kingdom from the comfort of our own homes. Was that all? It's already set up? I don't have to go to a story arc this time? This is the script?
But this is content that can be considered unreleased, rather than lost. These videos never made it through production, let alone onto Jon's channel. Those that have are accounted for. However, Jon himself has several channels, both well-known and obscure. The most noteworthy of which being a little co-op Let's Play channel called Game Grumps. Maybe you've heard of it. Obviously, Jon has long since stopped having a hand in content production, but in the channel's infancy, there are over 600 videos featuring him, and about 20 are known to have been taken down. The entirety of a 12-part Link to the Past Let's Play, all 4 parts of their Bayonetta playthrough, as well as 2 parts of their Banjo-Kazooie series, Episode 13 of Pokemon Emerald, 36 from Sonic 06, and Part 2 of Animal Crossing Wii, seemingly because of a lot of JonTron's vocabulary. Take from that what you will. But all of these are archived, and it doesn't appear as though his co-host Aaron is keen on deleting any more of them. Aside from Game Grumps Forever, Jon has had several other side channels, particularly from early on in his career. In 2011, Jon created 2 others called JonTron LOL and JonTron StarCraft. They served as Let's Play channels for League of Legends and StarCraft, and could be seen as precursors to Game Grumps in some way. JonTron StarCraft sits with 4,000 subscribers and has posted 2 videos. According to all the records that exist from the Wayback Machine, this is all it ever uploaded before going inactive, and is untouched to this day. But unfortunately, the same can't be said for JonTron LOL. Apparently, Jon put up 17 videos total over its history before eventually quitting and privating all but 4 of them. I searched for the rest and found almost no trace of them. Which, yes, does mean that 13 videos Jon made are still lost media, even after everything. Which may come as a shock since almost everything else he has been made public as of now. But these aren't JonTron videos. Rather, they're videos Jon himself has appeared in outside his core content. Main channel videos are thankfully safe, but Jon hasn't always had the same main channel. 4 years prior to the creation of the JonTron channel, he put up BirdmanXZ6, which was a channel sharing his Newgrounds username from a year earlier in 2005. Today, very little remains of whatever content had been posted to it. Records only go back so far, but 2 videos are public today, and 3 more remain unlisted but are accessible from early Wayback Machine captures of the channel when they were online. All you have to do is grab the link from when they were public, put it into YouTube now, and you can find them. But beyond these and a few animations on his Newgrounds page, any other content produced around this time is lost. Most famously, the Tales of Super Jon videos. These were story-based facecam videos where Jon would make up adventures he'd been on under the persona of Super Jon. For years, these were never confirmed to have existed until being featured in a video by, you guessed it, the Gamer from Mars. The Super Jon videos first resurfaced when he showed clips in his JonTron Internet Hall of Fame video.
Back in the early days of YouTube, Jon Jafari made a channel where he produced small skits including the Tales of Super Jon, in which he told stories in front of a low-quality camera. Even though these videos didn't stick around for long, they were still Jon's origin on YouTube.
I remember being on campus one day and asking a man who looked quite homosexual a question. I asked him, "Do you like men?" His response rather shocked me. He replied, "Are you fat?"
At the time, no one knew how he'd gotten a hold of them, and the following year, after receiving a lot of questions from fans about the topic, he made the aforementioned video dedicated to JonTron's lost content. In it, he gives an official explanation, saying he'd downloaded them himself 6 years prior.
The account that I want to focus on today, though, is a YouTube channel. Before JonTron, this was the account that he used to make videos, but unlike the Newgrounds and Yahoo Answers pages, content that used to be on this channel is not there anymore. These videos were taken down years ago, with little being known about them. The page on the Lost Media Wiki for these videos reads, "Following Jon's move to his more popular channel, he privatized all but 2 of his videos on his old channel. The existence of his Tales of Super Jon videos was confirmed in a video made by the Gamer from Mars." Hey, wait a minute, that's me! Ever since I made the Internet Hall of Fame showing the footage of the Tales of Super John, I've gotten tons of emails, tweets, and comments asking me where I found it. I've ignored these messages up until now, but I figured this would be the best time to explain the story behind the Tales of Super John videos. This story starts in 2010 when I first subscribed to JonTron. I think at the time he only had 7,000 subscribers, and right from the start I was a huge fan of his videos. When him and Peanut Butter Gamer started up the Normal Boots forums, I was one of the first people to sign up, and even though I was probably a cringy teenager at the time, I was pretty active on there. The reason I bring all this up is because on those forums, someone posted John's old channel, and I was able to check it out when there was 3 videos of interest on it. Two of these videos, which I found fascinating, were the Tales of Super John episodes, which just had him sitting in front of a camera like I am right now.
Right before my eyes lay a gaping hole. Creativity and imagination. At this point, I looked the entire people of the world in the eye and said in a loud, thundering voice, "Prepare for a new age of Super John and possibly communism."
Of course, the tales that he came up with in these videos weren't actually, you know, real, but rather just comedic stories that he invented. Shortly after that forum post, the videos were quickly privated, but I was able to get the 2 Super John videos before they were taken down.
2 of these were Super John videos, and the 3rd, which he hadn't grabbed, was a music-based video. He stated that due to himself being a public figure, releasing the 2 videos he had would be risky should John choose to sue him over it. So, unfortunately, his hands were tied and the videos continued to be lost. However, 7 months later, on September 23rd, 2017, a VidMe user known as Harrison Hopper put up a short snippet of one of the episodes that had been previously unseen. He claimed to have the full versions of both, but was waiting for the approval from John himself before releasing anything. However, this never occurred, and once VidMe shut down, all had seemingly been lost. Although, 4 days after this video was put up, a man going by Sexy Abraham on YouTube, claiming to be the friend of Harrison Hopper, released another few seconds of Super John, stating for copyright reasons he hadn't been given the rest. When asked directly 2 years later, however, he'd apparently gotten access to the full versions. Whether he intends to release them or not still remains to be seen. And these are the only people to have publicly come forward. It appears there's no shortage of people who have access to these videos, but everyone involved is too hesitant to release them without direct approval from John. Which appears to be all but impossible since John limits his public appearances and fan interactions. And even when large channels like Gamer from Mars address the subject, it still goes unresponded to. But speaking as someone who's been watching a lot of this play out for years, I don't think John's approval is something you all need to worry about. He's stated many times that content he removes is taken down because he grows dissatisfied with it, or it no longer fits with the channel. As far as I know at least, he's never stated that he wants deleted content removed from circulation, even when these videos have been completely privated and missing for years. If you want proof, look no further than his lukewarm response to seeing Apples and Brakes resurface when asked about it at MAGFest 2015.
Alright, so I have 2 questions. Yeah. 1, what is your reaction to Apples and Brakes being released by someone?
Oh, that happened like 2 days ago.
Yesterday.
And it's funny because he came over like on the 22nd and said, "Can I ask you something? Can I see Apples and Brakes?" And I showed it to him. And then the next day it got leaked. Some guy had it burned on his DVD. Well, congratulations. Now you have that worthless video. Yeah. What is my reaction? I think it's funny that somebody had it burned on a DVD. I don't care.
He's never directly stated if the Tales of Super John is a different matter, but given his stance on all other pieces of Lost Media, I think it's a stretch. So to anyone who may or may not have the full unedited versions in their possession, maybe the time has come to release them. I just wish I knew someone who had access. Someone who is obsessive with preserving Lost Media to the point of genuine concern. Someone who's been a longtime JonTron fan and who's passionate enough to have something like Super John in his possession. Maybe some YouTube nobody with 60,000 subscribers and the time to dig for something as obscure as Super John. If only we knew someone like that. Okay, yes, I have them. And am releasing both so you can finally see these videos in their entirety. But to those who wonder why, and why I and countless others commit so much time to digging these things up, the answer is simple. Out of love. I love JonTron's content and its history and want to do everything I can to share it with others who feel the same. This is usually what Lost Media hunting is all about. Even when the content can be mundane or unimportant, it's the mystery that makes it so coveted, and the hunt that makes finding it so satisfying. That's what made Apples and Brakes such a sought-after piece of media despite it being a relatively meaningless video on its own, and what makes it so fun to talk about in videos like this or the 10 others I've made about other creators. Usually, that's the farthest it goes and I don't actually release the content I dig up because, like Gamer from Mars said, "It puts me in a risky position since YouTubers are a lot more vulnerable than anonymous users with nothing to lose. Even though I'm much smaller than a person like Gamer from Mars, I'm still not exactly in the ideal position to put it out, which is why I haven't done so with other things I have. And just so you know, I did try my best to get in touch with JonTron, but like everyone else, big shocker, I couldn't get very far. Still, I wouldn't be doing this if I wasn't sure about how he'd feel, and I'm willing to accept the responsibility if I do end up being wrong. I don't mean to sound so serious about it, but I do want to explain myself in case this does ruffle some feathers. But without further ado, I present the Tales of Super John videos, which will both be linked on screen as well as in the description where they'll be uploaded on my alt account, as well as in a downloadable archive.org folder. But just remember, this isn't the end of the search for John's content. We still have the mysterious third video and the other 13 missing League of Legends uploads. Enjoy Super John, but it's not over yet.